So today we're talking about how to make money, which right now I'm doing probably a pretty good method. It, enchanted netherwood sells for a fair amount, like 500 coins. So that's good money, but you'll need a lot of money to start out with, because you can not spend money by just getting a sand minion and just making the soul sand yourself, but it would be hard. And then another way of making money that I just realized is if you go like hub one or anything, you'll find almost everyone selling snow minions. You buy one of those for 500k, you have like another 150k to upgrade to tier 11, then you sell it for a mil. That's about a 250k profit, I think. About that, maybe 150. Okay, but that's super easy money, because then you just buy another snow minion, and then you just put it back up. Then eventually you increase to like two snow minions, then you just keep on doing that a ton until you get enough. But another great way of making money is obviously farms. Let's see, we have a sugarcane, and then got a potato and carrot over here. I would recommend, if you can afford it, getting replenish. But that's not necessary. Also, the axe is pretty nice too. A cocoa bean farm is really good. I'm doing netherwort, and this is pumpkin. This is going to be pumpkin soon. We just started on it though. Cactus. Great AFK will farm. As you can see, we may have this up for a few weeks, but as you can see, it's just about full of cactus. Then you just put down a few auto smelters, and then you just let it fill up. Not auto smelters, whatever they're called. And then another great way of making money is to get Endermite pet, and then just keep on killing zealots in the end. Not zealots, Enderman in the end. Like the 9,000 health ones. Then what you do is just get Raider's Axe, level it up a ton, and then do that a lot. Also, another great way of making money is sometimes these like upgrades will sometimes go for a lot. Like this Builder's Wand. It would cost you me. So I can make profit off this because it would cost me around 3 cookies, which is about 3 mil, I think. And then I can sell for 4 mil. So I make a mil profit. I just buy a few more cookies. As you can see, I bought one. But then you just buy a few more cookies. You do it all over again. Then you just AFK on your island. But it's real easy money. And you see, I'm building up the netherwood farm, but that'll take us a little bit. I'm trying the, what are money making methods? Oh, a really good one if you knew about this at the time. You could have built, voted for Scorpius and gotten at least 50k. But sadly, you can't do that one anymore. Because Scorpius is no longer mayor. I don't have 1.4 mil with. I don't have 1.4 mil at all, actually. And so, sorry, I can't buy a minion. I mean, I would 7 of Among Us, but I would buy it, but I just don't have the money, and I couldn't even, like, trade you a snow minion or anything, because I don't have any of those either. But thank you for subscribing. So those are like the main money-making methods, but if you really want to make money, I think the snow minion method might be the best. Because all you need is a fair amount of starting money, but then it's all profit from there. I don't think one point, like, not even 1 mil, it's just like, maybe like 700k. Isn't that bad, but it's still kind of pricey for a money making method. But obviously, farms are just the best way to go. Especially now with this builder's wand. You spend, I don't know, like maybe 100k on everything. You build like a melon and pumpkin farm. Then you just build up from there. Now, it's probably mainly going to be like us planting netherwort now, because we have to do this for the farm. So also another way of making money, if you can sell them, it's possible, but the enrichment swappers, they're really good, because they're very cheap for bit-wise, but they don't cost much for bits, and they sell for about 50k, so it's really good for making money, just they're hard to sell, because not many people buy them. Oh no, I didn't mean to do that. Sorry, Max. Maddox. Whatever. Should we do some revs? That's the big question. Should we try upgrading our combat a little, or should we just make money by planting a farm? So chat, what should we do now? I can stop playing Netherworld, like we could go grinding. Right now, I'm at the point where like I'm mainly grinding. Because I know this is a stream about making money, but like all the money making methods I don't really. I mean, Netherworld is really good. Because it's so cheap to get. The soul sand isn't that expensive. And it's just, it gives you 500 coins per netherwort, enchant netherwort. If you build a few full with farms, then you're making big money. So I'm just, sugarcane is really good, but sugarcane has dropped extremely in price, and it's good for getting up your alchemy level. It's okay for money, not really, but it's more useful for alchemy. Oh, another great way of making money is just like get me a cheap pet and then like max it out, and then you can sell it for probably about double what you paid for it. And really, that's just a good money making method because you want to level up pets either way. Because like this bat, if I get that to level 100, sell it during a spooky festival, I'll probably make like double my money that I spent on it. And I can just mainly get that from collecting minions. If I have like a few snow minions down that I need. I sold all my snow minions today to buy the builder's wand. But I feel like it's worth it because I built this farm in about, I don't know, 2 minutes. So that's the main reason why you should get builder's wand. But I would wait a little bit because they're new and very expensive. But definitely they're, sometimes the most you sometimes the things that you don't even think about are the best ways. Like I realized today that you can make money off snow minions. Because I never really thought, oh, you sell them for about a mil when they're tier 11, then they cost about 500, 550k when you buy them at tier 1. Costs maybe 150k to upgrade them to tier 11. So let's see, at max, let's say it's 160k. Then it would just be like, at most it could be, so like 710k. But then you make another 290k profit, no taxes. But then you just made 290k from nothing, from a 500k, and you got the 500k back, and you can just buy another snow minion. This will probably take us a little bit, but it'll really help us out in the long run. Cause this is my co-op profile that me and Luke are doing, but. So we'll need these eventually, and it'll make anyone a ton of money. Because once you get replenished on the hoe, then you just keep on farming. That's why I think a cocoa bean farm is the most, one of the best farms, because you can easily get, not easily, but you can get replenished books, and then you just sell them on the age for like a mil. That's also, because the cocoa beans do not cost that much. If you had the recipe, you'd probably for enchanted cocoa bean. Well, not enchanted cookie. You could probably make an enchanted cocoa, enchanted, oh, replenish book for much cheaper than like just buying the enchanted cookies. I won't place down this one nether wart. It's annoying me. Get there. So I'm just trying to, I've thought of those few, but like I haven't thought of that many money making methods. But I definitely think the snow minion is, if this video gets popular, then the snow minion might become more expensive to sell and cheaper to buy. Well, more expensive to buy at tier 1, or cheaper maybe, but. Cheaper to buy at tier 11 because there would be so many. Because I mean, you could get lucky and get like I did one time, 14 gifts, and got 2 snow minions. But they, and then you could upgrade into tier 11, which that would cost you just the gifts alone would cost you a li maybe like not even 100k. Then you would just made over 200. Over about 500k profit, probably closer to 450, but that's all profit. And then you could just sell those, or you can make even more by upgrading to tier 11. But the presents are the riskier move. I'll let other people do that and then just buy the snow minion. from them. Because they're still making massive profit. If you wanted to do that, though, you could. But you might lose more money. So that's the only thing about the present method. So I'm just trying to think. So hot potato books are also really good. But the only issue with potatoes is they give you about no farming XP, which you probably should farm pumpkins first, even though they sell for less. Because you can then farm more potatoes, that'll get you more money. Let's see, so we just about gotta go back and get more netherwork. But this farm will be very, these farms are very useful. Because they cost you near nothing to start out with. Maybe some cost a little bit more than others. But for the most part, you can get, like, if you, for a netherwart farm, you can put down a sand minion, a mushroom minion, a spider minion. You got soul sand. Then what you do is you just, you put down a netherwart minion. And then you just make soul sand, and then you put down the farm. We only claim BK. And see, I built a little bit of an AFK cocoa bean farm, and that will be really, that'd be really good, because at the end you just teleport back and you just keep on breaking all these. You obviously can plant one more row, but then all you do is just you rotate back here, then you break more, then that, if you make it bigger, you eventually could just have it where you could AFK probably overnight. But I don't have it that big enough yet. I don't know why I always come down. Go down to like the other side for some reason. It looks so weird when you do this. It almost looks like you're going backwards. Alright, let's start playing up the farm. I'll probably do one more thing of this, then I'll probably start maybe doing some res. I'm just talking at chat. So, chat, what should we do, zealots or endermen, or should we do revs? Actually, never mind about the revs, I don't have enough money. I spent all of it on this nether wart. Let's see, so I think I'm just gonna finish off this, then put this row, then just put all the netherware in a chest. There, do we have enough room in here? I know my ender chest is a mess. I just don't have the time to organize. I don't care enough to organize it. Oh, and as you can see, we got a hilt of true ice. They're selling for actually really cheap now. Oh, I forgot about this. They're selling for really cheap now. Because, I don't know why, they're selling for like 350k. They used to sell for like over a mil every single time. I honestly don't know why. So let's, oh wait, this chest. Oh, there we go. We gotta remember that. So let's go ahead and farm up some Endermen or Zealots. Let's just see here. Oh, that's where everything is. Let's take out this. This, and this. Throw this in there, and... yeah, we're good. Oh wait, we need to pull out our Endermen. There we go. That'll help our damage. Wait, there's some- every lobby there's someone with a frozen sight. See if we can get summoning eye. Then we can probably do some stuff. Chat, when do you think we're going to get our summoning eye? What number? The average, the normal amount of zealots, like the average, is 420. So we're at 340 right now. See how many it takes before we get that summoning eye. Nice, we got some chain in the press. Let's see, we gotta call the same defender. Why is there just pulling on some right here? Is that? It's like actually there, I think. See here, more zealots, come on. Just need one summoning eye. Why are so many? As you can see right there, my average is 92. I'm at 300. Almost. Well, I'm closing on. More. At 400. But still. Why? Well, obviously, zealots are one of the most profitable money making methods. Because all you need, mainly what you need is an AOTE. But, like, because that'll help a lot. Also, yeah, unstable armor would help, but preferably young, if you can still one-shot them. But obviously, if you can't one-shot, go unstable. Because it's just... all this is just so profitable. But if you can, if you want to test your luck, you can try grinding the Enderman. Because those can give you a legendary Enderman pet. And that, oh, that's scary. I thought, oh, did I get summoning eye? But nope. It just did that. What are we doing, Drake? I think we are. See if I can get some free fires in. Go ahead and start pre-firing. Protect, are you kidding? Let's get some progressive frags instead. Progressive frags are more profitable than any drag. So where are some other frags? Let's just kill zealots instead. I hope I get a few hits on. So I got one crystal. Let's just go like this. Okay. How we still haven't killed the protector? Okay, where's some frags? Where's the frags? Where are you? Holy shit. Yeah. I need crystal frags. So. I think I got final hit. Protector frags. That's all for it. Considering I didn't spend anything, so that's good money. Oof. Imagine getting protector armor. If you're not going to do drags, what you are doing in the end, if it just happens to be a dragon fight, get the crystal frags, because those are... because those are more valuable than usually the frags, unless it's like a superior. Now the zealot should start respawning. What? Oh, we're doing our drag fight? Okay. Can I get two eyes really quickly? Crit spike? No, enchanted obby. Oh, are you kidding? Wait, what? There's who are these guys? Nice crystal powder, let's go. Now we got a few shots off on him. Let's just kill a ton of zealots. Let's look around for crystals occasionally. I haven't placed anything, so it's not worth it, really. I really did it that way. Let's look here. Is there no first break? Why have I not been in so many nights? I have 10 more before I load my library. He just died to an old dragon. And he's dead. So you're gonna get a crest spike real quick? No. Yeah, I've gotten 2 crest spikes so far, so that's not bad. Oh nice, I'm gonna switch to dragons. I'm gonna grab this. Those old pieces don't sell for anything, really. They sell for maybe 100k, but one summon there costs more than that, so it's not. Unless only dragon that's really good, it's superior for obvious reasons. But like, let people who do drags for a living do that, because you can just buy it for like probably half as much as they spent just get the one piece. All dragon parties do is they pray that they get some of their money back. Not nearly. They won't get all their money back ever, because it's just like, it just takes, you need like 3 superiors to get a decent amount of money. Yeah, let's see, I know there's some spawn right here. Come on, die. Die. This is average. Nope. We had an average of 92. Now we have like, now it's above like the normal. So we should be expecting one soon, I guess. Oh, we're doing another one? Okay. I didn't get up right now. Wait. Oh, that's just the Unstone Protector, but he's on stage 2. Young, that's not bad. Crystal. Nice, we got a crystal. Okay, where's some others? I need crystal sparks. Where are some more crystals? I need a crystal fragment. They sell for more than most dragon frags. Okay, yeah. Nice, we got 17 bits. Let's see, how much damage do we take? Not even close. Oh, we got 3. That's not bad. As long as we stay in this lobby, that's gonna be good. Because that means we still make a little money. Oh, yeah, enchant iron ender, that's cool. And that's about another 100k right there. Unless, I say unless it's a superior, I say we just try grinding out zealots no matter what. Well, let's see, where they go. They might be placing again. Where's that? I also don't get, I get leeching, but like I don't get actually doing dragons. Let's see. Yep, we're doing air drag. Superior, come on. Are you kidding me? Protect her again. Nice, I got one crystal. Are there any others? Let's go find some zealots now. Protector's like literally the worst dragon. The only thing good you can get out of it is an AOTD. Which sells for only 3 mil. And that's usually enchanted now. Gee, that was quick. And we got 3 more protector frags. Oof, protector leggings. None of that is good. I guess we picked a good lobby. Cause why is he wearing fairy armor? Let's see over here. Oh, they left. Oh no, someone else placed. Hey, wait, there's no another crate. Crystal fire, let's go. 45k off one zealot. Why have we not gotten a summon yet? It's like been so long. Oh, how did I not kill that one? There we just need one special zealot. Oh, go this way. Yes. I'm probably gonna stay grinding till I get at least one summoning eye. Because that, I am determined now to get summoning eye. It's probably going, probably now that I say that, it's probably going to be like all night for me. Or I can just get an egg belt kill maybe. Nope. The best ones to kill are probably, well obviously, ones with the pull frame. But also, also ones with like the bot ender chest. Usually there's always like one mage back here. Kind of like zealots. Oh, green box. Oh, I just enchanted that stone. We can't like get an end stone bow. But here we go. No one. Nope, still nothing. Green box. Enchanted obby. That's decent. Not like great or anything. But like, I'll take enchanted obby over. Enchanted endstone because it sells for more. I think endstone protectors give you actually the same amount as like whatever it's called, belt. Yeah, they do. There we go. Yes! Let's go! Let's go! 499, the one for 4,000. I think we're gonna definitely bend on that. Yes, the summoning eye. Let's real quickly. Wait, what? A plasma? I wonder what, I don't even know what that's due yet. So let's see, how much would this instant sell for? So let's see, young dark frags don't sell for much. Chain of Iron Ender, honestly. Let's see how much the frags would sell for individually. So let's see, 3,000. Young is just completely dropped in price. No, I'm not really interested in wheat or I'm not really interested in any minions because it's just like I can. It's better if I grind it myself because it's just I unlock the. The unique minion. There we go. Oh nice, we sold one summoning eye. $500K. If you didn't just see that, we just got summoning eye in the stream. And we did a few drags. We just leeched off them, so we didn't get much. But if you haven't, maybe if you want to go see that, just go back a little in the video. Yeah, that makes sense. Let's just scout the auction house real quick. See if there's anything good. Blue carpet, new. You know what we're probably gonna do? Not sure who that is. Yeah, it's just a Discord advertisement. No, okay. Yeah, but we're okay, we're gonna spend the mill on buying a snow minion. And then we're gonna max it out. So we'll do that real quick. So we're gonna go to any main lobby. Okay, there we go. How does this server already have 5 people in it? Let's see, is anyone selling a snow minion? Usually have to at least has one person selling. What does that even mean? See if we can get one. think the stream will allow you, but see if we can get a snow minion. Let's think it. Let's just sell these two and so I guess no one's gonna buy these if they're smart. Why do I hear? Oh, someone has a summoner staff. That explains it. I was like, why did I hear zombies in the village? Give them tier ones. Alright, so I'm gonna die, nothing. Ooh. Got four coins, nothing good. Oh, here we go. Now one we can open. Ooh. Ooh. Yes, there you go. No, about you, no. There, I know nothing. Thank you. became two bosses here. See if we can just find one person selling a tier 1 snow minion. Let's try a different route. This one isn't going to be good. No, that one's going to be even worse. Here we go, I have 9. Let's disconnect real quick and see if that fixes it. I'm not honestly sure what that means. Let's see if that fixes it. There, that probably fixed it. There's like very few. Yeah, there's still very few people in lobbies. We just need one snow. He's probably gonna cancel it. Not a good sword though. Hey, YouTube. Hopefully we can get up there one day. Hey chat, what should I make a video on next? Let's see, where's another fairy here? Oh, let's just wait around for a second. I was waiting for someone to like party me. Why was that literally the first next thing someone said? Let's give it a second. I know it's selling them right now, sadly. Let's see if this flip will work. Why? A Rookio is way better. It's just a Discord server advertisement, I was hoping. he was selling. I just need one snow minion. Why does this take? It used to be so easy just to get a simple. Looting for it does not cost that much money. But let's go maybe to the dark auction, try that out. We might just try buying a flower minion with 600k. Let's see if that works. There it is. Alright, wait a little bit. So what will we win at the dark auction, chat? I really have a smart idea. Let's see if this will work. Now let's leg it. We gotta leg it. Alright, good. I'm the only one in this lobby. I wonder if that means I can get into a private dark auction. I'm not sure if that does mean that. But let's try. This gives me a higher chance, though, of actually clicking on the guy, so on Cyrus. We always stand, so let's just spam like right here. Okay, let's see. None of the abilities are. Oh, there it goes. About a minute. Let's see if we can get in. Is there kind of. No, I can't. Lane lands right here, so. Let's hope that we can get in. This. Okay, a minute. A minute. This will be my first ever dark auction that I've ever went to. Now, our sole goal is to get flower minions so we can upgrade it. get in. It'd be funny if it worked like if you were in, it was just your lobby, then if you had a private lobby, you could just get anything. Okay, 10 seconds. Oh, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes! I got it! There it is. Okay, here we go. Yes. Hey, Bob. I don't feel like getting back in line. Hello, Bob. Oh, hey, Scorpius. Nice, 6 rounds, so that could be good. Chat, what should we try getting? Let's see. Flower Mini! Oh, no. Should we try... See how much this goes for. Yeah, it's too much for us. Yeah, everything here is going way overpriced, so we'll probably just try, hopefully just try getting the flower minion. And then hopefully a mill for a wither artifact. That's insane. Well, I've never been to a dark auction, so that could be cheap for all I know. So let's hear it. Chat, what do you think we'll get, if anything? We're not getting a Midas, I can tell you that. Or the shovel or whatever. 9 mil. I don't go to many dark. Haven't gone to dark auction yet, but that feels like a lot of money spent on artifact. It's probably gonna go up to 10 mil. What's next? Protection. Ooh, 7 book. That doesn't seem good enough for probably how much it's gonna go for. 800k already. There. What's next? Ender artifact. That seems pretty good. There goes. Oh, that'd been epic. Yeah, that's already too much. I can't even bid. I think I need at least a few mil to be at the dark auction, but like, I want to try getting a flower minion.
They just posted no.
Hold on, flower. Power set. Aww. That's such a waste. Let's see if I can win it. Let's see if anyone else bid that. I'm probably. Yeah, no. We have 6. Let me ask him. 6 mil, we only have 6k. 600k. I don't think we're winning anything here, so I think this was a waste of time. So yeah, we're probably not winning anything here, but... that's probably going... see if I can win it. And yeah. I just want something. I don't want this to be a waste of time. What does this even do? Oh, I thought that was Cambo QT for a second. Oh my god. We're probably not winning anything. Oh, that's funny. I just wanted to nip it. I think the flower minion is the last thing we got. That sucks. I just wanted a flower minion. Oh, come on, a Midas staff, the first Dark Auction I've been to in a year. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? It's the first Dark Auction I've been to, and they have this. It's insane. I want it, but I can't get it. Once I get a ton of money, I say I... oh guys, I already bid 100 mil on it. Ooh. See, I think that's it. That sucks. We didn't win anything. I think that's going to be the end of this stream, but thank you for tuning in.